jump. Amen. And I said Deuteronomy 13th chapter. Now begin reading at verse 6.
Amen.
It says, if thy brother, the son of thy mother, or thy son, or thy daughter, or thy wife, or the wife, I'm sorry, of thy bosom, or thy friend, which is as thine own soul, entice thee secretly, saying, let us go and serve other gods, which thou hast not known. Thou nor thy fathers, namely of the gods of the people which are round about you, not unto thee, or far off from thee, from the one end of the earth even unto the other end of the earth. Thou shalt not consent unto him, nor hearken, listen, give attention to him. Neither shall thine eye pity him. Neither shall thou spare. Neither shall thou conceal him. Hindus, but thou shalt surely.
Thank God for Jesus.
But thou shalt surely kill him.
Yeah.
Thine hand shall be first upon him to put him to death, and afterward the hand of all the people. And thou shalt stone him with stone that he die, because he has sought to thrust thee away from the Lord thy God, which brought thee out of the land of Egypt, from the house of bondage.
Amen.
Y'all hear that?
Yeah.
Now, in the book of Judges, the 6th chapter, chapter, begin reading verse 25. Says, and it came to pass the same night that the Lord said unto him, take thy father's young bullock, even the second bullock of 7 years old, and throw down the altar of Baal that thy father had, and cut down the grove that is by it.
Yeah.
Build an altar unto the Lord thy God upon the top of this rock in the ordered places, and take the second bullock and offer a burnt sacrifice with the wood of the grove, which thou shalt cut down. Then Gideon took 10 men of his servants, and did as the Lord had said unto him, and so it was. Because he feared his father's household, and the men of the city, that he could not do it in the daytime,
my Lord,
but he did it at night.
Amen.
And when the men of the city arose early in the morning, behold, the altar of Baal was cast down, and the grove was cut down that was by it, and the second bullock was offered upon the altar that was built. They said one to another, who have done this thing?
My Lord.
When they inquired and asked, they said, Gideon, the son of Joash, have done this thing.
Yeah.
Then the men of the city said unto Joash, bring out thy son, that he may die. Because he hath cast down the altar of Baal, and because he hath cut down the grove that was by him. And Joash said unto all that stood against him, will ye plead for Baal? Will ye save him? He that will plead for him, let him be put to death while it is yet morning. If he be of God, let him plead for himself. Because one hand cast down his altar. Now I told you I'm not going to preach. But if I was going to preach, then I would talk about fighting for what you ought to be fighting against.
Amen.
Just so you have an idea where we at. Fighting for what you are supposed to be fighting against.
Amen.
Now, I said I didn't feel good, and I feel like if I fell out right now, that you got something to think about.
Amen.
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 That you can see the condition of the world we live in.
Yeah.
Our society, our country, our nation.
Yeah.
And the world, and find that something is mighty wrong.
Lord.
And as many folk as know God, and as many folk as seek God and call on the name of God, you'd have to know that we should be able to enjoy far more blessings from God than what seemingly we do.
Amen.
I'm not talking about just life. I mean, we know life in itself is a blessing. But there are some things we've learned about life that we count as great blessings. And certainly the scripture says that if you be willing and obedient, that you can eat the good of the land. We have looked at this and studied this. And the first text we read comes out of the book of Deuteronomy, where one of the five books that are considered the books of Moses, where God, after delivering Israel out of Egypt, gives them laws to govern themselves by. And the law did several things, and one of the most important, I think we should get from it tonight, is that the law gave us a perspective of how God felt. Praise the Lord. There are certain things, set things in the law that teaches us how we ought to live even right now. Even those of us who say we're not under the law. And you can better understand God when you look at the laws that God made. Praise the Lord. I was reading earlier where in the law God said that even if you had a neighbor who you hated. See, in the Old Testament you could hate. That was the New Testament where hate. Jesus told us not to do it. But in the Old Testament, in the law, it said if you had an enemy or a neighbor that you hated, and you saw where his donkey had overloaded. And the weight that the donkey was carrying had somehow flipped on top of the donkey. And you understand, he got under it and he couldn't get from under it.